After 24-year-old Mollie Tibbetts was attacked and killed this summer by a man who's accused of following her on a routine jog, we were all hit with another wave of suggestions for how women can stay safe while doing normal activities. But what if that's not the only solution?
We're teaching our culture that it's all on us to protect ourselves. We're not teaching anybody, hey, don't do this.
Just this month, a 14-year-old girl in Oklahoma was stabbed repeatedly by a male classmate at school because she told him she only liked him as a friend when he wanted to be in a relationship. So what's the best age to learn consent and how to handle rejection without violence?
There's not an age where it's too young to teach consent. There's actually been research saying that even talking to your one-year-old about consent and what about healthy boundaries looks like is appropriate. We need to be teaching kids that saying no is okay. It's not selfish to say, hey, I don't like this, don't do this.
A relative of Mollie Tibbetts posted this message on Facebook saying that Mollie was murdered because a man denied her right to say no. Experts in abuse and violence prevention say it's well past time that we start making sure everyone grasps the concept of consent.
Healthy boundaries, consent, accepting rejection, all those things are for every individual.
Potential victims can attempt to prepare themselves with self-defense classes and pepper spray, but for real prevention, we'll need to start long before that.
It's about education, preventative education, about knowing what's causing these people to believe that they can act this way with others.